Francia defied the odds and won their first Copa del Rey since 2008 as they eked to a 2-1 win over Barcelona at the Benito Villamarin. Barcelona were the clear favourites heading into the clash, having wrapped up La Liga title with ease and created the better chances whilst also dominating the possession, but in the end they didn't have an answer for Valencia's pace on the counter-attack, which left them shell-shocked. First half goals from Kevin Gamero and Rodrigo Moreno sent Los Chis into the halftime break with a 2-goal lead, with La Blaugrana coming out firing to start the second half. After squandering a number of opportunities, Lionel Messi got his side back into the game with a quarter of the game remaining. Barca fought until the very end, but just couldn't find an equalizing goal as Valencia stunned the footballing world and took home the Copa del Rey crown. Here's a breakdown of the night's events. Barcelona, key talking point. Barcelona were looking to secure their fourth domestic double in 5 years, and having won the competition in all of the last 4 years, they would have been confident heading into the final. Unfortunately for them, things didn't turn out the way they may have expected, with the team still appearing to be suffering from the hangover of Anfield. They had no answer to Valencia's threat on the counter-attack, and although they dominated the stats in terms of possession and shot, they couldn't find an end product. They would have been desperate for more silverware after being dumped out of the Champions League in the manner which they were, and will instead be left bitterly disappointed with Valverde's future at the club seemingly in doubt. Player ratings, starting 11: Sillison, 5, Semedo, 5, Beek, 7, Leglet, 6, Alba, 5, Rakitic, 6, Busquets, 6, Arthur, 5, Roberto, 5, Messi, 8, Coutinho, 6. Substitutes: Vidal, 6, Malcolm, 7, Olaina, 6. Star man dash: although it wasn't to be Barcelona's day, Messi was still their main threat on the night. He was up to his usual tricks, causing havoc amongst the Valencia defense, and got his side back in the game with a poacher's finish to make it 2-1. He went close on a number of other occasions and even struck the post at the start of the second half, but unfortunately, after carrying his Barcelona teammate for the majority of the season, he couldn't carry them all the way to a cup win. Valencia, key talking point. Although the odds were stacked against Valencia heading into the final, they had proven to be tough opposition for Barcelona during the season. In both La Liga meetings, Marcelino's men held La Blaugrana to draws, with Valverde's men unable to get the better of Valencia, and the final followed a similar pattern. Valencia were clinical when they needed to be and were strong in defense, the perfect recipe to upset Barcelona. Their work rate was unrelenting, and their pace caused the Barca defenders all sorts of problems during the course of the game. Yes. Did. It was their first Copa del Rey triumph since 2008, and they thoroughly deserved it after a defiant performance on the night. Player ratings, starting 11: Dominic, 9, Wazis, 6, Gary, 6, Paulista, 8, Guy, 7, Soler, 7, Pergio, 7, Coquelin, 7, Guns, 6, Moreno, 8, Gamero, 8. Substitutes: Condogbia, 6, Pixini, 6, Diakhaby, and slash A. Star man dash: it was a fine display from the whole team, and a number of players could well have been recognized as the best player, but had it not been for John Dominic between the sticks, Valencia certainly wouldn't have won the trophy. He made a number of fine saves at crucial times in the match to deny Barcelona and to keep his Valencia side in the driving seat. In the end, Los Chis won by a 1-goal margin, which highlights just how important Dominic's saves were in helping his side win the cup. Looking ahead, it was the final action for both teams in their respective seasons, and whilst both sides came away with silverware, both may be left feeling they could have had more. Barcelona were dumped out of the Champions League, having taken a commanding position in the semi-finals against Liverpool, and losing to Valencia topped off what was a very disappointing end to the season for Valverde's men. As for Valencia, they'll be delighted with the Copa del Rey win, but may feel they could have done better in the Europa League against Arsenal.